Scattered through this rough, broken landscape of the West Texas desert exists a survivor, a nomad of this vacant land. The desert bighorn sheep has been seen by only a few. And if it were not for a handful of biologists, the bighorn would be gone from Texas forever. At the turn of the century, pioneer cattlemen, the railroad, and permanent civilization established themselves in the mountains of western Texas. Until this settlement of Europeans, as many as 2,000 bighorns roamed freely here. Today, because of man's influences, there are no native Texas bighorns left. Wanting to repopulate West Texas with the desert bighorn, Texas Parks and Wildlife began capturing sheep from other states and moving them to the land they once roamed. Having never been done before, the first attempts at capturing the bighorns were highly experimental, with each capture teaching biologists something new. The first efforts at capturing bighorns took place in southwestern Arizona. Tom Moore was in charge of the operation, and Don Frells was a student intern at the time.
We started the Bighorn Project in 1956. We had quite a bit of experience catching and transplanting mule deer and antelope, but bighorn were a different matter and different terrain. The program at the end was very slow. We took 3 summers to do it, to catch what we considered 13 prime sheep.
At that time, we were catching them in net fences built around the water hole, and people watching that particular trap, and if a sheep went in it, they just reached over and cut a wire that went over to the trap and held the door up, and the door just fell behind them. And then we'd wrestle with them a good bit, and it'd get kind of western now and then, and we'd give the sheep a shot of that tranquilizer, and then strap him on a stretcher, carry him down the mountain, and put him in the truck.
We had one old sheep in a trap, so I put a rope around his antler, his horns, and I said, let him go. And so down I went with him, and I had the end of the rope, and he followed the trail down to the truck. And then we just stopped, and he took a breather, and I did too. We took 13 sheep back to Texas. And I'll never forget the first lamb that we saw. That was a real red-letter day when we were looking at those sheep and we suddenly saw a young lamb nursing a ewe on top of one of those hills.
During the 1970s and 80s, two completely different capturing techniques were used, one in Mexico and another in Nevada, each with very different results. Jack Kilpatrick was in charge of the bighorn sheep program and the captures during those years.
Not much comparison, except that we were, both trips we were after sheep was about the only comparison. One using a capture dart with drugs, which are highly dangerous, and another is, physically restraining animals that are baited in under a net. The helicopter tranquilizer darts that we used in Mexico, we would locate the sheep that we wanted to put a dart in it, and then we would back off until the drug took effect, and we'd get a hold of the animal and strap it down, and then we'd fly out of the mountains with it. We caught 12 head. We lost 4 of those, basically to drug problems, problems with them being pregnant. Utilizing a drop net like we did to get those animals out of Nevada, you have to bait an area, and whenever you see the animals under there you want to capture, you just fire off a charge. Then you just have to work them out of the net and hobble them and blindfold them to them to restrain them. We brought back 15 head. Well, no animals were lost to injury or anything. Between the two, it's a very, very more successful, highly successful compared to the old capture dart method.
Raise some cheese, baby.
In 1994, from the mountains alongside Lake Mead in Nevada, Texas Parks and Wildlife captured 20 bighorn sheep and transplanted them in Texas. Doug Humphreys was in charge of the operation.
We'll be using helicopter net gun techniques. Nevada has the resource. They have a lot of desert bighorn sheep. And like other states that have an excess or a quality number of sheep, they're willing to help out other states that are trying to do restoration work. The desert bighorn, it's not just a sheep, it's a sheep that has adapted to a very hostile, sometimes a very unpredictable environment. In some places you're amazed that anything could survive in some of these areas where you find desert sheep. So I think they're survivors. We're trying to do something for future generations, not just for the immediate gain of, yes, we have sheep in Texas. I think it'd be better to have our grandchildren think that they've always been here and they never knew that they had to be restored, that they just take it as natural.
How many do we have left?
We'll be taking blood samples, testing for a variety of known diseases to wildlife and to domestic animals. We're going to collar all the adult animals that we do receive from Nevada for monitoring, especially the first 30 to 60 days. And this way we can keep track of sheep movements. For some of the rams, we'll take they call them pit tags. It's a permanent ID tag. And what it is a transducer, very similar to a barcode on a box of cereal or something like that. The only difference is we have to drill a hole into the horn. We'll epoxy the little pit tag glass canister that the transducer's contained in, and you'll glue that into the horn. As long as you can find the horn and you have a wand, you'll get that unique ID code for that animal.
Time you're ready.
Loaded in the trailer, the 20 captured sheep settled down for their 22-hour ride from Lake Mead, Nevada, to the Black Gap Wildlife Management Area in Texas. Proud and free, these bighorn will find new life on this open land, land their ancestors called home.
There goes Mama. This is when a biologist gets his pat on the back when you get to see the critters do that. I mean, that makes it all worthwhile. It really does.
There you go.
To me, it's exhilarating to know you had some small part in securing that foothold for that population. I think that, for me, is what personally just keeps me going.
History has taught biologists how to refine their techniques in capturing and relocating wild sheep. Because of these lessons, there are over 300 desert bighorn sheep in Texas today, and their future looks promising.
This population will grow and expand, and more animals will be populating the Big Bend area of Texas. That's the whole hope for a lot of us. It's not just for us or the short term. We're looking long term, way past my career and many others. That's our legacy. We want to get it in one condition, but leave it in a better condition than the way we found it. And I think this kind of a transplant is a step in that direction.